Hello, welcome back. It's about 6:30 on a Monday. I'm just about to head to the gym. I'm going to film a little bit and then I'm going to go through my five tips to get into fitness for you. Okay, cheers, bye. It's Tuesday morning, I'm just at work now. I didn't really have time to film anymore last night, so I think I'm just gonna go through now my five tips for success on your fitness journey. Okay, so number one, decide on your goal. So you need to really be honest with yourself about what it is you're trying to achieve. Are you trying to lose weight? Are you trying to gain muscle? You know, you need to decide what it is that you're trying to get out of exercise. So once you know what your goal is, it's so much easier to know how to train your body. Okay, so number two, pick a plan and stick to it. So there are so many plans online from, you know, personal trainers, Instagram celebrities, people like that. And it can be a little bit overwhelming trying to make a decision because you think to yourself, well, I want the best plan. You know, I don't just want to pay money for something that isn't going to get me results. But realistically, they're all the same. You have the, you know, basic categories of, you know, plans that are like HIIT workouts or HIIT with a bit of lifting or maybe just completely heavy lifting programs. But within those different categories, you know, they're all doing the same moves, pretty much the same formulas. It's just their own creative flair on it. As a newbie, you can get really bogged down in the nitty gritty and, you know, it's not necessary. I can say this from personal experience. Any movement is good movement. But I think it is really important to have a plan because it just gives your workouts a structure and also gives your week structure. If you know that you're going to the gym Monday, Wednesday, Friday, great, that's non-negotiable. And you know that you're then turning up for that. If you're just kind of thinking, oh, well, I might go to the gym tomorrow and I'm not really sure what I'm going to do, it doesn't really set you up for anything worthwhile. Okay, so if you don't know where to start, I'd recommend Cassie Ho's Blogilates Pit 28 program. That's the first program that I bought and I used it for months and months. Got really good results with it. You know, Pit 28 is a killer, but it is doable and it's adjustable. I think one of the biggest benefits of her program is not only that you get, you know, the PDF with all the plans on it, but there's videos on the online portal which show you how to do the moves, and you know, Cassie does the workout with you. And the most important thing is that you don't need a membership to do this plan. I still stick by this. I said this on one of my first posts on my blog, is that you don't need a gym membership to get fit. Okay, so number three is leave your pride at the door. You know, we all hate being bad at stuff, it's human. But if you haven't been working out for months and months, when you walk into the gym or your living room, wherever, it's gonna be hard. You know, eventually you learn that actually everybody in the gym is working to failure. Even if that person is, you know, super fit, you know, their workout is tailored to push them to their maximum, to keep going. And, you know, you will find that, you know, experienced gym goers, they fail their reps. You know, that's the nature of the beasts. Don't feel embarrassed because you're like really red in the face or that your bum's in the air or whatever, because I can assure you that when I'm in the middle of my own workout, I'm sure as hell not paying attention to what other people are doing. I'm too tired and too focused on what I'm doing. You know, the only people that are going to be looking at you are maybe the people doing a steady paced jog on a treadmill, and honestly, they're not worth your tears. Don't worry about looking silly or a little bit unsteady. You know, just give it all you've got. You know, that's why you're there. You're there to push yourself. Okay, number four, be patient. You know, don't expect to have abs by the weekend. Other people will notice your progress before you do. You know, when you look at your body every day, it's very difficult to see all those changes. But you know, it'll be a few weeks and, you know, one of your family members will go, hey, do you know what, you're looking pretty good, you know. And those are the moments we go, do you know, actually, yeah, it has been worth something. So, you know, be patient, it will come. If you go to the gym, you will get fitter. You know, you might not see instantly defined muscles from a couple of weeks of training, but, you know, focus on the other benefits of fitness. You know, think about, oh, it was actually a lot easier to climb the stairs today. If you're worried about thinking, oh, you know, what's the point if I'm not gonna have abs by Tuesday, you know, focus on those good things. And number five, and I think this is the most important rule, is do not forget your diet. I think most people watching this video will be in the same boat as I was. You know, you want to get into fitness because you want to look good. There is no amount of exercise that can outdo a bad diet. It's disheartening and it's a waste, because, you know, if you're putting in all this effort, you want it to show. So all you need to do is just make sure that you eat clean whole foods. You know, stop eating all the sugar and the fast food, because the better you fuel your body, the better not only will you look, but you'll feel. But on top of that, make sure you're eating enough. You know, it's so tempting in the new year, if you feel bloated and you think you've overdone it, just to, you know, go on a juice detox or 1200 calorie diet, you know. And I say that because I've done it and it doesn't get you anywhere. As much as I'm saying, you know, eat clean and stop eating all the rubbish, but equally make sure you still eat, because, you know, I'm talking, this is all tailored around fitness, because if you're going to the gym and you're cutting your calories too much, you will be too tired. You will not be able to have a successful workout if you've eaten a slice of toast all day and that's it. You need to eat, because you're just gonna be malnourished, tired, grumpy. You know, if you want a nice bum, you're gonna have to eat your protein, do your squats, you know, that's just the formula. It's the movement, but it's also the fuel. You wouldn't expect your car to run on no petrol. So give your body the nutrients it needs and your workouts will be so much better. Just make sure to eat your greens. Okay, so I hope you like this video. If you enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up and please subscribe, because it really supports my channel. But yeah, so when you go to join a gym in the new year and, you know, you want to get back into fitness, just remember these five tips, and hopefully it will then mean that this is about a lifestyle change rather than a quick fix. I hope you all really enjoyed this, and I'll see you all later. Bye.